In the last video, we said that this is the best Lewis structure for BrO2-. At first, it looks like it is. Each of the atoms has 8 valence electrons, so its octet's full, and we've used all 20 valence electrons we started with. However, bromine is in period 4 of the periodic table, and it can hold more than 8 valence electrons, so we really need to check the formal charges. For oxygen, and both oxygens are the same, on the periodic table, oxygen has 6 valence electrons, minus non-bonding, so these ones here are not involved in the chemical bonds, so we have 6 of those, minus bonding electrons, these two right here, but we're going to divide that by 2. 6 minus 6 minus 1 equals a minus 1. Therefore, both of these oxygens have formal charges of minus 1. For the bromine, it has 7 valence electrons from the periodic table. Bromine has 2, 4 non-bonding valence electrons, and it has 2, 4 bonding electrons. I'm going to divide that by 2, so we end up with a positive 1. If you add all of these formal charges here up, you will get a negative 1, which makes sense because it's a negative ion. However, we'd really like our formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible. Here, of course, we will want the negative 1, but we'd like the other ones to be 0. If I move these two valence electrons here to the center to form a double bond, and then recalculate my formal charges, I'll find that the formal charge on this oxygen is now 0, as is the formal charge on the bromine, and this final oxygen here with a single bond has a negative 1 formal charge. We still have our negative 1, so that this is a negative ion, but now our formal charges are much closer to 0, making this the best Lewis structure here for BrO2-. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.